golly. You're not supposed to see me. Oh no. Be quiet. I don't want to scare you. This is where I reside. I don't know what to say. Please just don't. Don't. Please. Is that what you think I am? You think I'm a monster? No one's ever called me a monster before. It's the first time that's ever happened. Trying to touch someone, my hand just goes straight through. Oh no. Oh god. Please. I don't want to get out. This is my home. This is my home. Ghosts are not supposed to interact with the living. No. No. I don't know what to do. Mommy and Daddy are going to be really angry with me when I'm with you. People call today a ghost. No. Well, yes, I like painting. Well, it's something that I used to enjoy when I was like you, alive. I didn't get to do it a lot. Well, I'm presuming by the look on your face you've never seen me before. No. Well, I wasn't planning on this moment in time right now. I was born here. Yes, this is an old house. Yes, I'm old as well, but most beings I know on this side are old. Well, it's natural to be old on this side. I have friends who are over 500 years. I shouldn't be telling you this. It's forbidden interact with alive beings. Oh yes, it is the same. If you are a poltergeist, like I am, you can move things. It takes practice. It took me a long time to pick up a paintbrush again and paint. It's the best feeling I ever felt when I could do that again, you know? I can't move heavy things. I can't lift. I don't know. A table or a chair. I mean, some of my friends can. But you have to be a very powerful ghost to do that. Yes. I'm practicing. I don't know if you've heard the table in your dining room shift about. You have. Oh, good golly, that is really good. I'm very pleased to hear that. How I died. Well, that's a bit of a sore subject to ask, don't you think? I really hope Mummy and Daddy do not find out about this, because if they do, I am going to be in a lot of trouble. So I need you to stay really quiet. Can you do that? I was born here. My mother gave birth to me here. In the barns. Well, they're not here anymore. Unfortunately, the barn does not stand today, but I used to love being outside, running around. I was best friends with a horse named Gadriel. It's a lovely name, don't you think? I'm yet to find her on the other side, but I won't stop looking for her until I do find her. I found my parents, but hopefully one day I'll come across her again. But that's not how I died. No, of course not. She was my best friend. Age of 4, I was taken away from my mother father. Well, I had no siblings. I was the only child. I was taken away by authority to a place where I was forced to work all day and all night with other kids the same age. We sometimes saw older people, adults, doing chores, but if one would interact with us children, drugged away by the gods, and I don't know what they did to them, but at night I would hear screams of pain. I believe that's what you still call it. I've heard that they're not a thing anymore, which is good. They don't want any being to go through what we did. Well, we had very small rations. Bread and rice and water. Sometimes, if we were lucky, and this was very rare, we'd have orange juice. But it wasn't very appetizing. No. It had bits in it that was clumpy and a bit nasty. That's what they would call a treat. I think not. I was forced to work on different chores. I would be on a rotor, so fabrics, cleaning, groundwork, well, I had friends. It was forbidden to interact with others, with you. No talking, no laughing. One time I saw two of my friends joking around, but they had it in for them. The gods dragged them away. I don't know what happened to them, but they came back with bruises on their face, on their arms, everywhere. Yeah, I was scared for my life. Well, time went on. Years. I don't know how I survived up until this point. I was working machines got stuck working. Something was stuck. A ball of cotton that was ruffled up below the machine had trapped the mechanics from working. And because I was short and I had small hands, the guards forced me to go under the machine and collect this. However, when I made my way under, a piece of machinery hit me in the head, in the back of my head. Everything went dark, everything went black. I couldn't see anything, couldn't hear anything. That was when I realized, moments later, that something was not right. I had been hit so hard in the head that it went through my skull. Everyone was screaming, apart from the guards. They did not care. They dragged my body, and I followed them, and they dumped my body. As a spirit, I managed to find my way back here, back home. I tried to communicate with my parents, but no matter how hard I tried, I couldn't. passed away of age. I would go out every day to see Gladriel, to see my horse, but she was miserable, as so was I. Stay the same way that you are when you passed away. I'm yet to find my friends from the workhouse. I don't know where they are. I mean, of course they're too scared to go back where that nasty, horrible place stood. I don't know if it still stands today. I bear to even think about it, but I can't help but not think about. Seeing my parents again when they passed away was something that I had been longing for what seemed like eternity. I cried, but I cried happy tears this time, knowing don't want to let them down if they find out that we've been interacting with each other. It's forbidden for a ghost to interact with a living being. The gods weren't looking, I would paint on a secret area on the wall inside. Well, we weren't allowed toys or anything that was fun. We had beds sleep on, but frames with the thinnest mattress. The audience even call it that, to lie on. And all we had to go toilet was a ceramic pot that stayed underneath our beds. It was cold and damp, even in the summer, a lot of times. Our clothes were not even clothes, they were just dirty rags. Covered in smoke and coal, dirt, dust. It was never clean. No. I think the guards enjoyed beating us up. Especially the older people. But you asked how I got hold of paints and a brush. Well, one of the older people that were at the workhouse at the time snuck us in some toys. Most of them got confiscated, threw away, not even donated to other families that were not in the workhouse. Society did not work like that. But I had a secret place where I hid my paints. My brushes, and when the guard was not looking or out on break at night, I would go out my bed and paint on a hidden part of a wall. I painted my horse with me, stood next to my parents, my mother and my father, and this house and the barn. That was all I painted. That was all I wanted to paint. The only thing that made me happy, you know. Well, I like pets quite a lot. Well, whenever I was in the workhouse, I would look out the window sometimes and see. Especially robins in the winter, just being free, and I wanted to be that. I fantasized about being a bird, and it was amazing to imagine myself flying away, and just being free to go wherever I wanted. All I had to do was spread my wings and fly. Do you like it? thought you just got rid of them. Well, I'm quite glad that your parents think that you're a good artist. I don't think I'm very good at painting, but people say I am, so maybe I should believe in myself a bit more. Relieved that you don't think I'm a monster anymore. We're not all bad. No. We just want to feel normal. Like everyone else on this world. Sure, one day I will find my horse. I know it. I won't stop looking until I do. I'm sure you'd be the same way if it was for you and your dog. Well, of course I know your dog. Sometimes we seeing supernatural beings, and cats, well, any animal, I think. I must say, he's a very funny dog. He does make me laugh. Yes, well, I must be going before my parents. My mother and father find out that I'm stood here talking to you right now. Well, thank you. Well, I will carry on painting whilst you sleep. Maybe one day one night. Of course, when my mother and father are not looking, and yours are not too. We don't want anyone else knowing that this happened. You have a promise to keep. I'm sure you will keep it. You seem like my necklace. Thank you. Well, seeing as I'm a poltergeist, I can show you this a bit closer. Aren't all that bad. Some are not very nice, but some are nice. I'd like to think that I'm a nice poltergeist. That kind of rhymes. It has clouds in it. Well, I saw it on your dresser. And I fell in love with it. Yes, that's why it disappeared. I'm sorry. I can keep it. Why, thank you. You are very kind. kinder than anyone I've met in this world. It has clouds in it. I'm gonna just stare at this all day, all night. Well, as supernaturals, we don't really sleep because, well, we don't need it. I think it's so pretty. It looks like something from out of this world. It reminds me of whenever I used to look out the workhouse window and see the blue sky and the clouds. I mean, all that's missing are the birds flying around. Thank you for letting me keep this. I treasure it. Yes, I do. It's just something that you can't stop looking at. It's absolutely marvelous, if I do say so myself. Well, I must go now. Well, I do hope we see you. As long as my mother and father don't find out. Well, it was very rude of me to not introduce myself at the start, but my name is Katrina. Well, it's derived from mainland Europe, but I was born here. My parents just really liked that name. Yes. Well, I do know your name already. I think it's a lovely name. Yes. Well, I must go now. I can hear my mother and my father coming, so I don't want them to see this. I do hope we see each other again. Now, keep painting, if that's okay with you. Yes. Okay. Well, I hope we see each other again. And do try and get some sleep. Goodbye. Cheerio.